when I first saw this thing, I thought it was just a big old cassette recorder, because all I saw from the top is just the speaker and the cassette mechanism here. And I looked closer and I saw the sleep control, and it says FM AM solid state digital clock cassette radio of the old Panasonic logo there. It has controls for the alarm and different functions, including a phono input. One interesting thing is the eject button says cassette up. On the front, we see that digital clock is actually a flip clock. Unfortunately, it is not working. I have it plugged in and that wheel's not spinning. But you can see the flip clock mechanism there. All the numbers on little tiles that flip over. And you get your alarm on the side here. There's the radio dial. On the side, we have controls for tuning, volume, and tone. On the back, there's the power cord. And we get connections for MPX output from the FM tuner, microphone input, phono input, and a jack called EP. I first didn't know what that means, but I think that means earphone. On the bottom, you can see the model number tag. Model RE-6600 FM-AM clock radio, made in Japan. UL listed, and there's the serial number. I think this is what that Macklemore song is referring to. Fortunately, the only thing working on it right now is the cassette and the AM radio. Turning on here on AM.
System have the
Ken Wings.com/Broadway Rocks for more info.
Wings News Time 5:49.
Very good sounding speaker. Try the cassette. Makes a very funny sound when you eject it. It's like a big spring in there. And try this tape here. Fast forward. There it goes.
Don't be quick to condemn her for things.
Excellent sounding speaker.
I'd say, just remember.
Let's try rewind. It's going along pretty good. Okay, let's try recording on this thing. Okay, recording. Okay, let's see how that came out.
This is testing using an external microphone with the Panasonic FM AM solid state digital clock cassette radio, probably from the early 70s, if not even late 60s. So let's see if this works.
Sounds like it might have a dirty record play switch, but otherwise it seems like the mechanism is working fine, which is unusual because usually the cassette is the first thing to break on these kind of things. On this one, it's mostly working fine while the FM radio, all you get on it It was just a little bit of hiss and hum. And the clock is not working either.
The music continues every Saturday night with Danny Stiles on AM 820 WNYC.
Well, with a little nudge, I was able to get the clock motor running, so it probably just needs to be oiled.
Great American Museum of Natural Historical Records. This is your Vicar of Vintage. Your Doctor of Archaeological Discology, Danny Stiles. The theme music that you hear is the original version of Charlie Barnett's Cherokee in my theme song.
By the way, that DJ has passed away, but they're still running his old shows on this station every Saturday night. WNYC, 8:20 a.m.
A youngster, this program is designed especially for precocious teenagers and for astute youngsters in their 20s and 30s. And, of course, mature adults in their 40s and over. Every Saturday night from 8 p.m. until 10 on WNYC, AM 820, that's New York Public Radio, I spin these classics. Guarantee you will hear them on any other radio show, anywhere. Like this original 78, it's an OK label. The vocals done by the trombonist James Young, better known as Trummy. Ain't She Sweet. This record goes back to February 7th, 1939.
There's the inside. Nice big power transformer. There's the cassette motor belts and wheels. There's the motor spindle itself down there. There's a flywheel, it's a metal flywheel. I should be careful poking my fingers around there because that's the main filter caps for the power supply. Still don't know why the FM is not working. Still only getting static. Or not even static, just hiss. So it's not picking up anything on FM. Still needs dial lights replaced. I don't know if the light in there is working or not. Here's the bottom cover I took off. How about this? They give you dial stringing instructions.
Jimmy Lunsford in the orchestra.
You don't see that
Did
anymore.
You know that Mr. Lunsford was Glenn Miller's idol? He said so in an interview once. This is Danny Stiles with Tommy Dorsey's orchestra next.
Next!
Here at the Music Museum. Tuned by Jimmy Van Heusen and Johnny Burke. Recorded in Nueva York City on April 10th, 1940. Frank Sinatra sings Imagination.
I can see why they're still running this guy's show even though he's dead. This is good stuff.
Imagination is crazy. Your whole perspective gets hazy. Starts you asking a daisy what to do.
Famous by Glenn Miller, recorded February 6, 1939, Ray Everly on the vocal, it's a bluebird. How I'd like to be with you in Bermuda.
How I'd like to be with you in Bermuda, without a thing to do but look.
look at you and scheme. We'll sit and sob Bermuda lullaby. We'll sit and sob and watch the moon grow higher.
Well, I took out a few more screws, and here's the other side of the chassis. Very vintage looking circuit board. And there's the cassette motor. That could be a date code there. 0969, meaning the ninth week of 1969. The cassette uses an electrical erase head. The AM antenna has these very fine wires soldered right to the circuit board there. So I have to be a little careful with that. I think this is the buzzer for the alarm. And there's the light bulb for the clock, which I believe is burnt out. And it looks like if you leave the alarm running, see there, the alarm tripped. But if we continue to move the wheel here, looks like in about an hour of the alarm going off, it'll automatically reset itself. So, unlike most alarms, which just run forever until you shut it off, this one looks like it'll reset itself in about an hour if you just let it go. And as for the radio dial, it uses two of these fuse-style bulbs, so those won't be a big deal to replace. And now, without even needing to oil it, the clock motor runs as soon as I plug it in. And that's a very quiet motor, so it's still perfectly fine. Thanks to Radio Shack, I've got the clock light bulb. It's a 6.3 volt bulb, but it's only running at about 4 volts. And I couldn't find exact replacements for these, so I use these automotive dome light bulbs. And the thing that happens, these are actually running in series. So when both bulbs were out, I was measuring like 9.8 volts. So I thought a 12 volt bulb would be good enough. But now that there's two of them in there, they're both running at less than 4 volts, so they're really kind of too dim for this application. I mean, it shows up okay on the camera, but in real life, that's really dim. So I'm going to need to find a more appropriate bulb. And I think what happened is one of these burned out by just failure of the filament, and then you can see the other one is much more black inside. And what happens, this 6 volt bulb was running at like 9.8 volts until it burned out because it was running at too high of a voltage. Because you can see when I take one out, the other one gets much brighter. See, that would be a good brightness for that dial if only they were both that bright. But put the other one in, they run in series, and it drops to half that brightness. So I will need to try to find the correct replacement. So the clock light is now working nicely, although there's still no dial light. I decided to take out these bulbs rather than leave them in there. When they're just going to be so dim, it's not going to be worth it anyway. One nice thing is that you can use the alarm to wake up to a cassette instead of the radio. You just stick in your tape. Make sure that's in the tape setting. You hit play. And then you turn on it to auto. And then once it hits the alarm time, it's playing the cassette. And it will continue to do so until the alarm times out and about an hour later. The alarm went off. And you can also use that to record from the radio at a certain time. So just stick in your recording cassette. You set this to AM or whatever band you want it to have it on. There's our station we want to record, so we just hit record and play. And we'll set it to auto again. And when the alarm comes on, playing the radio, and it's recording to cassette. And again, after an hour, it'll time out, and the cassette will stop if it hasn't already stopped because it reaches the end. You want to play that back. There's our recording. So, can be used with the alarm to play or record a cassette. And of course, it also has a buzzer. Which also times out after about an hour. And if you use this phono input, you can also use it to record from an external source at the time the alarm goes off. So that's a really nice feature there as well. And of course the sleep timer works with the cassette as well. Just hit play, and it's not going anywhere until you turn on the timer. And when the timer goes out, it stops. That earphone output on the back is actually powerful enough to run an external speaker, so that's nice. Well, it's a few days later now. The correct bulbs arrived and I installed them, and now we have our lighted dial the way it's supposed to be. Nice and bright, and the clock is also lit up with its own bulb in there. So this is pretty much fully restored, except the FM still isn't working, but everything else is working fine, and I cleaned it up a little bit, and it's looking much cleaner now on those controls there. Very good AM tuner in this.